If you're the creative type like me, you love to draw, but drawing space is always at a premium because your office, being a creative person, is always a mess, especially like me. Now, let me show you what I mean. So look around. Do I have a drawing table? I do. What does it do? It's cluttered with all my projects that I haven't gotten to yet, or unfinished projects that I'm going to get to. But I haven't used that thing as a drawing table in a long time, and the moment you put it flat, it gathers stuff. So finding a good space to draw is always a challenge. Well, I'm going to show you how to make a drawing board, which makes that a very easy problem to solve. I love using a drawing board because I can slide it next to my desk and it doesn't take up any space. And then whenever I need it, I just pull it out and I can actually just set it up on my desk, or I can simply just pretty much lay it on top of all my junk and it doesn't even bother it. But what's cool is I have a little lip on my keyboard tray, but you don't necessarily need that. But it's awesome because I can use it when I want, and then I can just pick it up and throw it somewhere when I don't need it. But the key to a good drawing board is it needs to be light. It needs to be a really good surface to draw on, and it needs to be stiff. You can't have something that's flimsy because it just sucks. Because are you actually going to draw on this? No, of course not. You're going to put a piece of paper or something on top of it. And I usually just rest my sketchbook on it when I do project drawing and stuff like that. But it needs to be convenient. So let me show you how I made this one. The first thing you want to do is get your materials together. First thing you need is a cardboard box. Any cardboard box will do, but ideally you want a big cardboard box so you can figure out the size of your drawing board and keep that drawing board size within a piece of cardboard that doesn't have any folds in it. And it works best with a bigger cardboard box, obviously. And if you want a huge drawing board, then you need a really big box without folds, and that starts to get really challenging to find. I have this one, which is gonna work out great because I'm gonna make four pieces, one, two, and then three, four on the back. So the next thing you need is you need something called chipboard. Chipboard is that very thin cardboard, and you can find this stuff in surprising places. One of the easiest ways to find a big piece of chipboard is on the back of those free calendars everybody hands out at work. And that's exactly where I found this piece of chipboard. Chipboard is just that thin cardboard, and the stiffer the better. No innuendos here. But it is, the stiffer it is, the better of a surface, because that's gonna end up being the surface of your drawing board. So I've got this piece of chipboard, and I'm gonna line it up on my regular cardboard box and figure out how big I can make my drawing board. So as I do this, I realize there's a fold right here. So I'll cut this piece of the chipboard off, and that'll be my template for the rest of my drawing board. Now we're gonna take our panels and we're gonna glue them together using some high strength spray adhesive. And I love this stuff. I use it for all sorts of things, especially labels and stuff. But it works awesome for this, and definitely probably the best application. The other thing I'm gonna do real quick is I'm gonna mark my panels, then spray them down both sides. Not all of them both sides, but I mean like both contact surfaces. Wait a few seconds and then put them together and create a sandwich of four layers plus my chip layer on top. Now, just remember, don't go crazy with the spray adhesive because you don't want the stuff everywhere, and you don't want it on the surfaces, specifically on the very back and the very front of your chipboard. All right, so let's get started. Last but not least, you want to create a little lip on the bottom of your board. Now, can you leave it just the way it is and it would be good? Absolutely, but I'm telling you, you'll realize pretty quickly the easiest way to use these drawing boards is to have a little bit of a lip on the bottom. So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create one using the exact same technique I just did, but I'm gonna use some of the scraps that I have left from when I first cut up my box. That's it. A super simple way to make an awesome drawing board. And I'm telling you, you'll love this thing because, well, a couple of reasons. Number one, you made it yourself. So you're gonna love it because it's custom. You could make it any way you want. Number two, it didn't cost you hardly anything. And if you go out and look and see how much drawing boards are out on Amazon or wherever, you'll be surprised. They're pretty expensive. And this one will work even better because it's lighter and it's got a great surface. I love the chipboard feel when I'm drawing and things like that. Well, that's it. If you've got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommandedDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.